Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So, in today's video, we are going to check out a plugin called Dehancer. Dehancer is a plugin built for DaVinci Resolve, and it's going to emulate old film stock. And in this video, that's what we are going to test out, and we're going to try it out. Quick disclaimer. The plugin were sent to me to try out and test out and to come with my honest opinion on. Nobody are going to see this video review before published. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get right to it. Oh, and by the way, if you are interested in learning DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and having a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's get right to the video. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve 17, testing out the Dehancer plugin. If you're interested in knowing more about the technical aspects of film stock, please do check out the Dehancer website. They have a lot of great information about the different stocks and how they work. Very technical, and they definitely know their stuff. So let's jump into the color tab in DaVinci Resolve here. So we are going to use this clip right here, which is shot on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K and a Siri 75mm lens. So let's use the plugin. And so what I like to do when using a plugin like this is to add in another note, Alt S or Command S, depending on PC or Mac format you are using. So we go all the way down here in our effects. And here we have film emulation, the Dehancer Pro 5.0, and I'm going to drag that into my second node. One thing you should do before you actually start to work with this is to go all the way down here to the film grain, and we are going to enable that or disable that. You can see what that does. It makes it very grainy. And if we want to use film grain, we'll do that later on. So the way the plugin works is you can work your way from the top all the way down here. And that's a pretty nice workflow as well. So first off, we're going to set up our input. So per default, it's set at Rec. 709. However, if you know what camera you're using, and in this case I do, I can change this to choose camera. And then I can choose what kind of camera it is. This is a Blackmagic design. I can change the camera, and I know this is a Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. I also know what format it's shot in. It's shot in film look. And already here we have done some great stuff. So we can go in and change around in our exposure if we want it to be a little lighter. And also we have the temperature slider. We can change the temperature. Think this looks pretty good. The next thing we can go in, I can just enable this as well. This is the film stock. So if I toggle that off, you can see what it looked like without anything. So I'm going to put in a stock. This is Coda Vision, but let's take another one. And by the way, there is a lot of different film stocks to try out. So you can use your afternoon testing out the different stuff. I think it's great. So let's take the Fuji one. You can see what that does. Looks pretty nice already. Then we can go in here to the pull push, and what we're changing here is the saturation, the white. So let's do something like that. Looks good. So we go to expand, and in expand is where we can actually change the black and white points of our footage. So if we want it to be like a little more contrasty, we'll take the black, push that up, and the white, we could do the exact same. We're going to lift the highlights here, something like that. And if we want to see what we have done, we can go up here and just toggle off. So already we have some kind of a look. So we can go into the print here. And now it's set on linear. There's different things you can choose around here. What kind of a print? In this case, I'm going to let the print be as it is because I think that is good enough. So we go to the color head, and here we can change around, you know, the yellow and blue colors, and we can do this pretty like we want. We can change around stuff in the magenta and green and in the cyan and red. However, I'm going to reset all of those and I'm going to push here. So I'm going to gag them together. So they are going to follow each other. So we can actually see if we push it towards the blue, we are making the image more blue. So, and we have to find a middle ground where we like the image. So I think something like there is good. We also have some preserve exposure, which means we can just change the exposure a bit. If we want to make it a little darker, something like that. And also the impact, that's how much we are doing stuff. So now we come to the film grain. And you see now I can enable that. And we can change around the size, the amount of grain. I don't want to have too much. The film resolution. I want to batch it down a bit as well. In the shadows, how grainy is it in the shadows? Something like that. So in this case, at least for this clip, less is more, I think. And also in the midtones, I want to take that down a bit. In the highlights, I want to take the grain down in the highlights. And the chroma aberration, we'll do something like that. So we also have halation. We're not going to mess around with that at all. Neither are we going to do with the bloom effect. Some people like the bloom effect a lot. I necessarily don't want to use it for this. We also have a vignette. We can enable that like so. And we're going to take the feather all the way out so we can actually see how big our vignette is. And then we can change around the exposure a little bit. I want to make it darker in the corners, so I'm going to take the exposure down. Then I can change the size. I only want my corners, something like that, I think would be great. And then, you know, maybe I'll take it down a little bit more. And then I'm going to take the softness and I'm going to soften all the way up like that. So you can see the difference here if we enable it or disable it like that. There's also film breathe. Again, for this particular thing, I don't think it does too much. Also, there's like a false color checker if you want to check out your false colors. So that is the basic of how the Dehancer works. It is a pretty neat tool for DaVinci Resolve. And actually, I think it's kind of helpful. It isn't a, what would you say? It isn't a one plugin, one button solution. You actually have to go in and work with the different settings. But if you want to invest your time in doing so, I must say it is really worth the time spent. Again, if you're interested in the plugin, check out the website or the link down in the description below. And I do hope you want to give this plugin a try. There is also a free trial as well as I remember, so at least try that out. So here's just a little sequence where you can see the before and after, and please enjoy that. So I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.